Are there any announcements that any of you would like to bring at this time. I know we have a minute for mission coming, but any other announcements before that?
Do we have a cook for Wednesday?
I don't know.
That might be one thing.
We'll figure that out. There will be food, one way or another. We will have food. So, just a couple things that we received in the mail that we thought would be good to share. One of which came from the Presbyterian Mission Agency, and that's a thank you for our contribution to Presbyterian World Mission. They talk about their ministries that focus on three global initiatives: alleviating poverty, sharing the good news of God's love in Jesus Christ, and working for reconciliation. They write, "We would not be able to pursue these priorities without generous gifts like the one you gave." And it's signed by Reverend Jose Luis Casal, the director of Presbyterian World Mission. We also received a thank you note from the Office of Multicultural Affairs at the university. A couple of weeks ago, we put on a reception for the faculty and staff of color, and they sent us a note saying, "We would just like to say thank you, tell you how much we appreciate the Bowling Green Presbyterian Church and its members for the kind support for the faculty and staff of color at the social last weekend. You're one of the most awesome community partners. The great role the church has been playing in our various programs is never goes unnoticed. We're so grateful for all your kind support and continued partnership from all of us in the Office of Multicultural Affairs." So just thanks to the inclusion team and to all who worked on that event. And I know that we also have a minute for mission from Lynn Long. Actually, it's just more of a recognition about an upcoming event. Push it down and hold it.
Now?
Yeah.
Okay. I have here a proclamation from the mayor. Several of us who are on the Crosswalk Committee went to the City Council meeting on Monday, and this was presented to us, naming October 15th, which is a week from today, as Crop Hunger Walk Day. And then afterward, we were asked if anyone wanted to say a few words, and Lynn Myers invited everyone who was there, and there were a lot of people there, to come to the Crop Walk, which will be at the City Park next Sunday at 1 o'clock, and mentioning that we will have food and music and hope to get lots of contributions. So if anyone wants this, I would see this later. I think I'll put it on a bulletin board by the office. And then I understand that next Sunday, there's going to be a noisy offering for Crawford. So I think Linda mentioned this last week, and I understand there's going to be a competition between the north and the south side to see which one raises the most contributions. And it doesn't have to just be coins either. And whichever side does, that amount is going to be matched by a member of our congregation. So I hope you will remember that next week. Sunday when the noisy offering comes around. Thank you.
Thank you, and again, just another plug for next Sunday. It's always a fun event and a good way to raise some money. If you're planning to walk, we can get you pledge forms and all kinds of things. You can do it online. Every other year, Presbyterians have outnumbered everyone else, so we want to have a good showing next week for the Crop Walk. If there are no other announcements, let's take a moment now and share the gift which Christ left his church, and share the peace of our Lord with one another.